If you're like me, you have loads of dies in your stash. You might have background dies, coordinating dies, border dies, word dies, dies, and they are not cheap. So for today's video, I'm gonna use this one die, it's a background die, and I'm gonna create 5 different projects with this one die. So let's see if we can stretch our stash, because God, by God, we paid for it. Let's figure out how to use it. I got carried away and made more than 5 cards. I made 11. This is what we're going to make in today's video, all with that one die. So this is the stained glass cover plate die. This is how it looks. I use the Gemini Junior die cutting machine. It is so great at these intricate dies, and I literally just whack the die on my surface until all the pieces fall out. And if any gets stuck in there, I use this pokey tool to get it out. If you don't have this, grab a toothpick or something, and then you have this beautiful, beautiful die. Right? This is what it looks like. You can die cut it white cardstock, black cardstock, colored cardstock, whatever. The first technique is let's do some stenciling with it. You can do stencils with your die cuts. You can reuse it if you use heavy cardstock. This is 110-pound cardstock, I think. You can use it over and over again. So I'm going to go in and add a couple different sprays here. These are Distress Spray Stains. These are really the only sprays that I have left in my stash. And then I've got 2 cards here, right? I've got the die cut itself and then the stenciled portion. This first card by far is my favorite. I just took the die cut and adhered it to some black cardstock, and that butterfly came from my magic mug. I will link to any products that I use that are still available for purchase in the description below, and also a link to my magic mug video if you're unsure what that is. And this second card is just a stenciled background with a word die and some washi tape. Super easy. Next up is some partial stenciling. It's the same thing. You can use the same die cut and stencil and use it as a stencil, but instead of spraying it or ink blending or whatever over the whole thing, we'll just mask off a little bit of it and just focus on that bottom corner there. And I'll just do some basic ink blending. I'm using Cove Blue and Serene ink from Catherine Pooler and just a blending tool I have in my stash. And then I'll just go on with those 2 different colors of ink blending. While I'm doing that, I want to thank Skillshare for sponsoring my videos today. I love Skillshare. I've been working with them for the last 2 years. I actually learned to watercolor from Skillshare. I love Jane Davey. She taught me how to do watercolored animals. Here is a look at actually one of her classes and how she walks you through painting this panda. I think it's absolutely fabulous. And she gives you stencils and guidance, and I love her accent and everything about it. And I actually painted a panda after taking this course. But Skillshare is so much more than watercoloring. It's got all different kinds of things and all varieties, from tying your shoelaces to flying a plane. No, I'm kidding. I don't know if there's flying a plane on Skillshare, but there's a lot of topics on there. And the first 1,000 subscribers to click the link below will get a month's free, so you can check it out. So I encourage you to check out that link below, see if it's your jam, and let me know if you like it. So I've gone ahead and blended those 2 colors, and then I lift it up, and then I have this partial stenciled look from the same die. Added some washi tape and a word die and flicked on some black paint for that card. You can also do swinking, which is just a word vomit that I made up on accident for ink swiping and inking. And I actually have a swinking techniques video I'll link in the description below too. It's got like 10 different techniques you can do for swinking. So I basically just took the ink pad and finished covering the panel that we didn't work on. And then I realized I can actually swink my ink pad through the die cut and do another stencil look, which is what I did here. And it's just, I just see circles. I see so many circles versus the intricate pieces of the die cut. So again, super easy to put together a card. And then I still have that die cut piece right there, still left. So literally I got 3 or 4 cards out of this one little stencil. So that's why I say kind of use thick cardstock and not flimsy cardstock, because you can really get some fun out of it. So I'm using some paste. This is the only paste I have left in my stash. I don't even know if they make it anymore, but it's by Nuvo. And I just partially went ahead and put some paste through that. So now I've got this as a background. And once it's dry, I was able to finish out this card very easily. And now that die cut panel that we've been working off of as a stencil, I can finally put that on a card. So it has sprays and it has the pastes on it and everything. And I just think that's a really cool look. And I didn't know what that was going to look like when I was done putting a bunch of stuff all over it, but I absolutely love it. Let's do some dry embossing this time. I didn't know how this was going to work either, so I'm just putting 3 pieces of white cardstock, running it through my die cutting machine just like I would if I'm die cutting it. And my hope is at least one of those images will be dry embossed. And to my surprise, I actually got 2 images with that die cut detail embossed into the cardstock. And then that third panel is just its regular die cut. So I was super stoked that I got these 3 like background. So here's the 2 dry embossed. One is very subtle. The other one is more indented. And then I've got my regular die cut panel here, which we'll use on that in just a second. And again, as I sat down, I really only went in with 5 technique ideas. And then I just kept playing around and, you know, hey, let's go ahead and swink on direct swinking to this paper and see what these embossed images really look like once you put ink on it. Because white on white, it's very subtle. So I'm inking up both cards the same way, but look at the different looks. Because one is a very subtle, it's not as deeply indented and pressed into the cardstock. And the other one is more pressed into it. So, you know, 3 cards. I got a 3-fer right here. Actually, a 4-fer, 5-fer. Because I'm going to get 5 cards from these 3 things, from this one die right here. So here's a look at the finished cards for the 2 dry embossed panels that I added ink to. And then I'm going to use that third die cut piece, just that die cut piece, the white piece that came out where everything was die cut. And I'm going to cut it up. This is a great way to stretch those dies. If you can look at it and envision some other images that you can get, go ahead and cut those out. Like I just see that big, huge circle in the middle, and then I see a bunch of little circles. Take your scissors and start cutting it up. It's just paper. You don't know what you're going to get. For this one, I just cut out the center circle because it was very obvious to me. And then I can line it up with another die cut that I just die cut with regular, which is colored cardstock, and line it up, glue it on there, and bada bing, bada boom, I got myself a card. Look at that. And I adhered all that to a piece of glittered cardstock just for added shine. But keep cutting it up. You don't know what you're going to get. So when I cut that circle up, I had that piece left over, that background piece, and I turned that into a card. I just added some ink to the top of it and turned that into a card. But wait, I had another background left over. That's actually using that cut up piece as a stencil. Let me back up. So I had this piece that I cut up right here, but I laid that over a piece of white cardstock and just ink blended right through that to create this stenciled background, which I already did earlier in the video. So I just did it again and I was able to get two more cards from that. So take a look at what you have left over, what you've cut up, what maybe you've done some ink blending on to act as a stencil. You can maybe add sprays, add paste, gel medium, paints, I don't know. Look in your stash, see what you have. But looking at your background dies and stepping back and trying to look at them in a different way will elongate the lifespan of your die because they are not cheap. Those are metal. They're not cheap to make, so they're not cheap to buy. So try to look at your stuff and say, hey, how can I get, even if you're doing the same techniques over and over and over and over again, it doesn't matter. If you're using a different design, a different stencil, a different die, a different stamp, you can still stretch it all and get totally different looks every time you sit down. That's what I encourage you to do. That's what my channel is all about. Get more bang for your buck. Thanks for joining me today. Let me know if you have any video ideas and I'll add them to the list, and I will see you again very soon.